सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू फाइव इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज। दिस सेशन गाइस इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी, सो डू वॉच द कंप्लीट सेशन एंड स्प्रेड द नॉलेज। बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन, एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेज एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेली सेशंस। और इसका जो लिंक है वो आपको डिस्क्रिप्शन में मिल जाएगा। ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। नेम द कॉन्फ्रेंस विच वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय श्री औरबिंदो सोसाइटी। सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द सोसाइटी, श्री औरबिंदो सोसाइटी। एंड दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड टू ऑनर एजुकेशन ऑफिसर्स एंड टीचर्स फॉर देयर कमेंडेबल वर्क ड्यूरिंग द कोरोना वायरस पेंडेमिक। ओके, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस न्यूज। सो दिस नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस is named as Empowering Through Zero. Okay, Empowering Through Zero, or in Hindi we can say Shunya Se Sashaktikaran. Okay, Shunya Se Sashaktikaran, or we can say Empowering Through Zero. And it was attended by our Union Education Minister Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, and it was organized, as I told you, by Sri Aurobindo Society to honor एजुकेशन ऑफिसर्स एंड टीचर्स फॉर देयर इनोवेटिव प्रैक्टिसेस ड्यूरिंग द कोरोना वायरस। जिस तरीके से उन्होंने इनोवेटिव तरीके से अपने स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाया है, टू ऑनर दोज इनोवेटिव प्रैक्टिसेस दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस हैज बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड। ओके, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन गाइस इज व्हाट, ऑप्शन ए, शून्य से सशक्तिकरण। एंड रिसेंटली डॉक्टर रमेश पोखरियाल निशंक हैज ऑल्सो वन द वटायन लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट अवार्ड। ओके, एंड वटायन इज अ लंडन बेस्ड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच gives international awards to the poets, to the writers, and to those to the artists. Okay, and question number 2 is, which organization has won the Platinum Partner Award in the awards instituted by the Ministry of Electronics and IT on completion of 3 years on Umang App? So yesterday we have discussed about the Umang App, and its international version has also been launched in some of the countries, and jo ki humne kal discuss kiya tha, and on the completion of its 3 years, some awards has been instituted by the Ministry of Electronics and IT, which is currently headed by Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. His Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib in Bihar. Okay, so let's talk about this news. So Ministry of Electronics and IT has instituted these awards for completion of 3 years of Umang App, and the name of the award is what? Platinum Partner Award. Okay, Platinum Partner Award, and this has been conferred on EPFO. Kisko mila hai? Employees Provident Fund Organization, for having फॉर डिलीवरिंग मैक्सिमम ट्रांजेक्शन ऑन दी उमंग ऐप। ओके, पिछले 6 महीने के एवरेज लिया गया था इसमें। ओके, द एवरेज ऑफ लास्ट 6 मंथ्स। ओके, द एवरेज ऑफ लास्ट 6 मंथ्स वॉज टेकन, एंड एज बेस्ड ऑन दैट एवरेज ईपीएफओ हैज रजिस्टर्ड द मैक्सिमम ट्रांजेक्शन ऑन दी उमंग ऐप, एंड दैट्स वाई दिस अवार्ड हैज बीन गिवन टू एम्प्लॉयज प्रोविडेंट फंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। ओके, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी व्हाट, ऑप्शन ई, ईपीएफओ। And now let's move on to question number 3. Recently, Union Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment, who is Mr. Thawar Chand Gehlot, and he is also the leader of Rajya Sabha, has launched National Portal for Transgender Persons and a Shelter Home for Transgender Persons. With respect to the initiative launched, identify the correct statement. So, 2 initiatives has been launched for the transgender. One is National Portal for Transgender Persons, and another is a Shelter Home. Okay. So let's talk about this, and these initiative guys of course will provide support to the transgender person to live their life with full liberty and respect. Okay, puri liberty aur dignity aur respect ke sath agar hame transgender ko life deni hai to hame unke liye kuch na kuch initiative start karne padenge, and these initiatives are one of those. All right, and the name of that shelter home is what? Garima Grah. Okay, remember the name of this shelter home also. Garima Grah is the name of the shelter home that has been launched for transgender person in Vadodara, and it has been launched where? In Vadodara, in Gujarat. All right, and talking about the portal, so how it would help transgender, so it will help a transgender person in applying for a transgender certificate and identity card. Okay, jo transgender certificate hota aur identity card hota hai wo digitally obtain kiya ja sakega through this portal. All right, so this portal will help the transgender person in obtaining the transgender certificates and identity card digitally without physically moving to any office. Okay, bina office jaye unko digitally unka identity card or transgender certificate mil jayega through this portal, and to obtain the transgender person certificate and an identity card is a very important provision of the transgender persons Protection of Rights Act of 2019. So I hope you all have heard of this act, the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Act 2019, that was, you know, enacted last year. It provides for this provision of obtaining transgender person certificates and identity card, and this portal will help in the same. And talking about the shelter home, so the basic purpose of this shelter home, and what was the name of the shelter home? Garima Grah. Okay, remember the name also, the Garima Grah is the name. And this shelter home will provide basic amenities to the transgender persons like food, medical care, recreational facilities, and of course the shelter. And it will be open in association with the Lakshya Trust. Okay, Lakshya Trust, this is an organization which is completely run by transgenders, and it is a community based organization which works for transgender, of course. So Lakshya Trust ke saath milke is shelter home ko chalaya jayega, and it will also provide support in capacity building or the skill building. Jo transgender persons hai, unke skill building or capacity building ka bhi kaam kara jayega through this shelter home, which is named as Garima Grah. Okay, so that's it about this news. Now let's come to the question. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding these initiatives. Okay, so the shelter home has been named as Adar Sansthan. So is that Adar Sansthan? No, that's Garima Grah. All right, so this statement is incorrect. The portal would enable a transgender person to apply for transgender certificates digitally. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And the shelter home will be operated in association with Lakshya Trust, and which is a community based organization, and it is completely operated by the transgender person. And remember one thing, that Garima Grah is inaugurated in Vadodara in Gujarat. All right, remember this information also. So third statement is also correct, which means only 2 and 3, option A will be the correct answer. And moving on to the question number 4. Recently, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, which is headed by Mr. R. K. Singh, his Lok Sabha constituency is Ara in Bihar, has amended the guidelines of Pradhan Mantri Kusum scheme. And Kusum stands for Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Maha Abhiyan. Okay, so with respect to the amendments, you have to identify the correct statements. Okay, so let's talk about the PM Kusum scheme first. So it was launched in the year 2019, and it has a basic objective of setting up of solar and renewable power plants of 25,750 megawatt capacity by the year 2022. 2022 tak 25,750 megawatt ka solar and renewable power plants lagane ka target hai under the PM Kusum. And these are the three components under the scheme. And for more details, guys, regarding PM Kusum, you can watch the government scheme session. I have covered it comprehensively there. So the first component A is the installation of decentralized ground mounted grid connected renewable power plants. Then we have component B, in which installation of standalone solar powered agricultural pump is there. Then we have third component, that is solarization of grid connected agricultural pumps. Okay, so these are the three components, and these are the amendments. And all the amendments you don't have to cover, you just have to cover these amendments, because बाकी जो अमेंडमेंट्स है वो यूजलेस है एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से. सो जस्ट फोकस ऑन दीज अमेंडमेंट्स. ऑलराइट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, पास्चर लैंड्स एंड मार्शी लैंड्स आर नाउ इंक्लूडेड, व्हिच मींस इफ देयर इज एनी फार्मर हु इज अ ओनर ऑफ अ मार्शी लैंड और अ पास्चर लैंड, सो ही कैन नाउ इंस्टॉल रिन्यूएबल पावर प्लांट्स ऑन दीज लैंड्स ऑल्सो. ओके, देन दो सोलर पावर प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं स्मॉलर देन 500 किलोवाट विल नाउ बी अलाउड. Completion period has been increased from 9 months to 12 months. 3 महीने का grace period दिया गया है for completing the projects. And there will not be any penalty on the shortfall of generation. अगर solar power plant के generation में कोई shortfall आता है, then there will not be any penalty on the farmers. All right. Then talking about components B, the ministry will keep 33% of the eligible service charges for national information, education and communication activities. Then eligibility of participation under centralized tender has also been amendment, and this amendment in detail you don't have to cover. Just remember that there are some amendments under the eligibility of participation under centralized tender. Okay, and amendment in component C, same as this amendment, MNRE will keep 33% of eligible service charges for IEC activities, or we can say information, education and communication activities in our country. Okay, so these are the basic amendments. Iske alawa aapko koi bhi amendment padhne ki zarurat nahi hai, that will not be asked in your exam. And most importantly, you have to cover the amendments in component A. These are very important. Okay, so now let's come to the question. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding the amendments. Pasture lands and marshy land are now included. Yes, this is absolutely correct. completion period has been increased from 9 months to 12 months. This is also correct. And MNRE will keep 33% of eligible service charges for IEC activities. This is also correct, which means all are correct. Option E will be the correct answer here. And now guys, let's move on to the question number 5, which is the last question for today. Consider the following statements regarding the report on National Nutrition Mission, which is also known as Poshan Abhiyan, that was launched in the year 2018 by Prime Minister from Jhunjhunu, Rajasthan, and it was released by Niti Aayog. So this report on National Nutrition Mission was released by Niti Aayog, and you have to identify the correct statements regarding this report. Okay, so let's talk about this report. So the report is titled as Accelerating Progress on Nutrition in India. What will it take? Okay, what is the title? Accelerating Progress on Nutrition in India. What will it take is the title. And this report analyzes the success, analyzes the implementation challenges of the National Nutrition Mission across the country. Okay. And talking more about this report. So it is the third progress report. Isse pehle do progress report aa chuki hain of the National Nutrition Mission, and it is the third progress report that takes the stock of rolling out and the implementation challenges of the National Nutrition Mission. Okay, and this report is based on the data sets of NFHS-4. Okay, NFHS-4 ke data pe based hai and Comprehensive National Nutrition Survey. So do alag alag surveys hain, unke data pe ye National Nutrition Mission ki report aayi hai. And remember one very important thing, that this report does not highlight the consequences of COVID-19 on the targets under the Poshan Abhiyan. पोषण अभियान के अंदर जो टारगेट्स हैं स्टंटिंग, वेस्टिंग और अनीमिया के, उनके ऊपर कोविड का क्या कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस होंगे, उसके बारे में इस रिपोर्ट में कोई जिक्र नहीं किया गया. बिकॉज दिस रिपोर्ट एनालाइजेस द डेटा बिफोर मार्च 2020. ऑलराइट, एंड दीज आर द कंसर्न्स विच आर हाईलाइटेड इन द रिपोर्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट, एट प्रेजेंट 1/3 ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन अंडर 5 इन इंडिया आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम आइदर फ्रॉम stunting or wasting, and 40% of children between the age of 1 and 4 years are anemic. Okay, and it also says that India's target on stunting is very less as compared to the global targets. In India we have a target to reduce the stunting level to 13.3% by the year 2020, while the global target is to reduce it to the levels of 5%. Okay, so we are far behind if we compare to the global targets. And the target of reducing prevalence levels of anemia among the pregnant women from 50.3% in 2016 to 34.4% in 2022. And if we talk about adolescent girls, it is from 52.9% in 2016 to 39.66% till the year 2022. So these targets, according to this report, are currently very difficult to reach. So we have to do something. The government has to do something. Okay. And that's it about this report. Now let's come to the question. We have to identify the correct statement. Currently 1/4 of the children are under five are suffering from either stunting or wasting. That's not 1/4, that's 1/3. All right, so this statement is incorrect. This report highlights the consequences of COVID on targets under National Nutrition Mission. No, this report does not say anything about the consequences of COVID. And 40% of children between 1 and 4 are anemic. Yes, this is absolutely correct, which means we have only one statement correct. Therefore, option D, only 3, will be the correct answer. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the news are clear and all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. Or Saturday, Sunday, there will be a session of government schemes. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.